no fear of being murdered, which is my way of saying that I'm online dating now. Here's my tip if you're new to online dating, never meet your new date anywhere where a jogger can find your body the next day. That tip is brought to you by the opening sequence of Law & Order. I was talking to one guy, and things were going really great. You know, we talk for hours, texting all the time. So one night I'm at work, and he's like, hey, we should meet. And I was like, oh yeah, totally. Well, I'm done at 10 o'clock. I know that's late, but maybe we can meet at a bar. And he goes, bars are lame. Which should have been my first red flag, because bars aren't lame. That's where alcohol lives. So I was like, well, what do you suggest? Because, like, I'm out of ideas, you know, 10 o'clock. And he's like, let's meet at the beach. Yeah, she's shaking her head. I wrote back, I was like, I prefer to meet at a bar or a diner where there are witnesses, people. And he wrote back, well, I don't want to meet you if you're scared to meet people. And then he never talked to me again. I was like, oh my God, you were totally going to murder me. So, I'm a survivor of murder. Yeah. Stories. It's been about a year now since my last relationship. And it took so long for me to start wanting to date again because I packed on 45 pounds within the first few months of that relationship. Like, I was getting ready to hibernate for the winter. At the beginning of the relationship, you know, he was telling me things, you know, like, with or without makeup, you're beautiful to me. I would love you no matter what you weigh. So I guess, like, subconsciously, I was like, challenge accepted. But yeah, so like being single again, like, you know, my girlfriends who are not single anymore, they always give you that advice. Once you stop looking for love, that's when it'll find you. Why don't they say that about other things, you know, like missing children? Billy's probably in the last place you look. Talking to a pretty new colleague of mine, and it mentioned my age in the conversation. I was 31. And he goes, oh really? He goes, I thought you were, you know, like in your 20s, like you just graduated college. I was like, oh my God, wow, thanks. I look like I have a degree. I posted that little comment online on Facebook, and my mom wrote, LOL, that made me laugh. Which is the first time she's found the humor in me being a dropout, so. That's nice. I've been a late bloomer too. You know, in high school, my friends had boyfriends, we were having sex. I was not. And so when I got older and like started having sex, like, you know, guys would ask me, tell me what you want, what you really, really want. No, that was the Spice Girls hashtag reunion. That's what they said. No, but like in bed, guys are like, tell me what you want. And like, I didn't know, like, what my options were. I was like, wanted you to have sex with me? And you're doing that? Good job. But now that, you know, I'm older, you've been around, not around. Now when they ask me, you know, a little older, wiser, more mature, it's like, what do you want? I want like a committed relationship. That's gonna lead to marriage and babies. What? Sometimes it's actually like, what do you want? Like a ham sandwich. I was like, I've never heard of that. I'm like, yeah, you have. It's a ham sandwich. Famished. Anybody else with bipolar disorder? Cool, because when you have a mental health disorder, you like to feel like you're alone. If you're not familiar, you have episodes of mania and depression. I mostly have the depression episodes. Basically, it's like this gray rain cloud over me, just like pretty sad all day, don't have any fun. Blah, blah, blah. I mean, it's not as fun as I just made it sound. But people will try to help me with my depression and like they're completely unqualified. You know, like they don't get it. They're like, oh, just go do things that make you happy. And I'm like, no, I need medication and therapy. That's like telling somebody having an asthma attack to just breathe better. Or somebody with polio to just walk it off. I was talking to my mom about my depression, and I was just like, I just don't want to do anything. I don't want to see anybody. I don't even want to perform. It's just so bad. She goes, well, I can understand why you'd be depressed. You know, you're not seeing anybody. You're broke. You're not where you want to be at in your career. Is this a pep talk? Never volunteer at the suicide hotline. So at the end of the conversation, though, she goes, now, you're not going to want to hurt yourself, are you? Well, I wasn't going to, but you've given me a lot to think about. Thank you.